Say hello, Nathan.
Hello.
So today, me and Nathan, we are gonna give you a tour of Shreveport.
Yeah. Is this a good light? I think we're kind of probably in the sun. Glare.
It's good. They can't see us very well.
Okay.
It's kind of mystical.
Preferred that way.
Yes, yes.
I see.
The first thing we want to mention to you guys today is the Tree of Life.
Tree of Life.
Nathan, you want to go introduce them to the Tree of Life?
So here we have this tree. It's kind of young, but it's been here for a very long time. on self camera, I think I'm bleeding. So this is the Tree of Life, as I mentioned earlier. And it doesn't look old, but it's actually quite old. And it's famous in this part of the state, Louisiana, for its longevity, but also how it's actually a dwarf Tree of Life. And it looks quite puny, and it puts out these small little, I don't know if you can see them, these little berries that look dried. So it's a deceptive dwarf Tree of Life. I don't know, I may come cut it down and make firewood out of it because it looks very warm. But anyway, on to the next thing. We'll show you some more exciting things, just like this dwarf deceptive Tree of Life. And Timothy now is gonna give us a tour of the channel Shreveport.
All right, this is the Shreveport channel. One notable thing about this is it's the highest point it's been all year. It usually is a slow trickle. It's fed from many sources, such as rain, precipitate. So where is this coming from? Good question. Here's one channel, as you can see, this pipe feeds into it. It's more of a slow trickle.
And if we go farther inside here, there is absolutely nothing in here.
It's kind of interesting. Here on your shoe.
Is it ancient?
I just hope it's not poop.
Oh, there's water down here. That's a bad idea.
So this is Timothy's butt.
I was trying to get to the other end, but there's a metal pipe about halfway down. It's smaller in diameter than this one, and I can't fit through that.
I'm glad this isn't poo.
So, right here. Get out of the way, kid.
They feature this fine orange marble, found only in the volcanic straits of northern Hawaii. Aside from the traditional like orange pastel pumpkin with the yellow eyes, we have this bark yellow or like mucus yellow maybe. Looks like he's throwing up some great goo. It's actually part of the history in the area. There's a hotel, the barking jack-o'-lantern. Anyway, there's this whole mythology, I won't go into it. They created this facade, which was loved so much they took it and they turned it into a park bench. Here, all bums sleep here, and sometimes occasionally they would sleep on this one. They grab newspapers from the surrounding trash cans, and occasionally light poo to get out of the channel on fire. I sleep on this table over there sometimes.
See, this is padlocked, right?
Well, the reason this is padlocked is this is the Shreveport Insanitarium. If you listen real closely, I think you can even hear the sounds of children weeping. It says the Shreveport Insanitarium. There's no other place like it in the world. Oh, well, I think they started calming down. But you would still be best to keep your distance, as you can see right over here on this sign. Warning. Stop, meaning don't go in there.
You can see right here, if you open or unlock that door, you need to immediately call this phone number right here.
They're gonna run crazy.
This is, again, mud. And the insanitarium, respect it. Have a fearful respect of it, keep your distance.
This is where the Shreveport
genius!
Versus with the poser.
Genius!
And this is a freaking
genius!
And I'm a freaking tree trunk!
Genius!